against the Boilers, or would inconsistency continue to plague them? We'll find out on Hawkeye Sports Magazine with Hayden Fry.
Quarterback, three receivers are set out, fakes the draw, he passes, and it's complete, and it's an Iowa touchdown, it's an Iowa touchdown! And here's Rodgers back to throw, he throws, he has a man wide open, Allen Cross at the 35, at the 30, the 20, and down to the 10, the 5, and he's in the end zone, Allen Cross open by... Just about ready for the play, the third ball is snapped, the kick is up, and it's long enough.
Sports Magazine with Hayden Fry is sponsored by Coca-Cola, always the real thing. Walkers, walk into Walkers. Iowa's better Buick dealer. The 175 Iowa Napa Auto Parts Store. Active Endeavors, where your outdoor adventures begin. Bristol Fisher Company and First Star Bank.
Coca-Cola package.
You get a Wild Hawkeye football.
Or Cyclone basketball. Plus,
look inside cans and you could win a Jeep Cherokee.
Other prizes instantly.
Have a ball.
I know a winning team when I see one, and there's one right here in Eastern Iowa. Your Iowa Better Buick dealers are scoring big with a lineup that's taking on the competition. Say yes to the quality talent and wide variety that Buick provides.
Say yes right now and get up to $1,000 cash back on the Buick Park Avenue. Say yes to Buick.
Get on the winning team. Say yes to Buick.
Winter, you learn to ski better with tips and techniques from ski's top teaching pros. Found at this all-new Ski Better Now video, yours free. Call this toll-free number today, and Ski Magazine will send you this video free with your paid subscription of only $11.94. Enjoy a full season of Ski Magazine, America's top-rated magazine for skiers. Beginner or experts reach new levels of ability. Call today to get Ski Magazine, plus your free video, and Ski Better Now.
Austrian Special Edition. From start to finish, Equestrian Special Edition is filled with action and special features about horses and the people who enjoy them.
I'm Ann Johnson. Please join me and my special guest co-host Sunday on Equestrian Special Edition.
Coach Hayden Fry, you said at one time the Hawkeyes were going to explode, and they did explode. I'll say that. What an offensive battle.
A great feeling, Jim, to see our offensive line improve, and that's the hardest I've ever seen our backs run. Well, Cedric Shaw and Ryan Terry did an exceptional job, and Burmeister had another outstanding game. And but that guy, number 42 for the other team, he's something else, isn't he?
Yeah.
He's really special.
Well, Ed Podolak was working next to me, and of course, the record he broke, the stadium record, was Eddie Podolak's of 286 yards.
Well, you know, I certainly want to give credit to Northern Illinois. But if he had a better supporting cast, no telling what he could do.
Oh, man, can that guy go, can he? But, hey, let's talk about your backs, Shaw and Ryan Terry in particular. First time you've had two backs go over 100 yards each since Nick Bell and Tony Stewart days.
That's right, and excellent blocking up front. And I've never seen both of those backs run that hard. I thought Terry and Shaw were just exceptional.
And you got to be happy, Coach. You got a chance to play a whole bunch of guys, particularly in the last half.
We did, the entire second half. In fact, we had a lot of substitutes in there when Johnson made that last 81-yard touchdown run for the other team. But nevertheless, we got to play a lot of people, and I think we came out of it physically in pretty good shape.
Well, that's great. And then with some additional people coming back, because certainly Northwestern and Minnesota proved that they're going to be tough customers.
It'll be extremely tough for us. You know, Minnesota traditionally, regardless of our record, they're very tough on us. They defeated us the last time we went to the Rose Bowl. But Northwestern's a team that's greatly improved. Illinois and Michigan State were extremely fortunate to win right at the end of the ballgame.
That's right. We'll talk about that later. Hey, let's relish the moment, and we're going to look at those first half highlights. Fireworks all over the place. Stay tuned.
The Iowa Hawkeye offense, inconsistent throughout most of the season, started the game red hot after converting a fourth and one.
It's now going to be second down and three, Iowa, at the 37 from where they actually spot the ball. The fake on the draw play, and Burmeister going for broke. Way down inside, it's an Iowa touchdown! Nemo Odom gets behind the defense, streaking down with track speed. A 34-yard touchdown strike from Burmeister to Nemo Odom. Well played, he got right in back of the
extra point gave the Hawks a quick 7-0 lead. Northern Illinois' offense couldn't move the ball in their first possession, and Burmeister and company took over and picked up right where they left off. Tailback Cedric Shaw put together two impressive runs covering 14 and 15 yards. However, Burmeister missed Anthony Dean in the end zone, and the Huskies capitalized on the mistake, picking off the Iowa quarterback on the next play to end the drive. Iowa's defense once again put the clamps on NIU. Mike Wells sacked Bart Geiser. Burmeister took the field, intent on making amends for his interception. After another good Shaw run, he hit tight end Ertis Crank for 26 yards to the NIU 7 early into the second quarter. The Hawkeye explosion was about to begin.
Playing a brilliant game today, and now here's a handoff on right up the middle. It's going to be a touchdown. It is Ryan Terry. Little counterplay down there at crisscross action, 7-yard line. Ryan Terry in the end zone for a touchdown. Great block down there.
Now down 14-0, the Huskies look to the nation's leading rusher, LeShon Johnson, for help. He didn't get any cooperation from the Iowa defense, and NIU punted away. Burmeister wasted little time guiding Iowa downfield.
And the ball is downfield, and it is complete to Jasper. Burmeister throws complete to Jasper down to the 32-yard line. And Iowa leading 14-0. Here's Burmeister, little delay. Off to the right side. Here's Cedric Shaw running with the ball. I think he's going to go. He does.
The last thing the Huskies could afford was a mistake, but a fumble by their star running back Johnson added fuel to Iowa's fire. Everything was going wrong for the Huskies and right for the Hawks. A botched fake field goal attempt would have given NIU a reprieve, but a personal foul penalty kept the drive alive and Iowa capitalized.
Now we have Willie Guy going in motion. Here's Burmeister, rolls out. Burmeister looks to Guy, wide open in the end zone. He passes to Ryan Terry. Ryan Terry wide open in the end zone. No one within 5 yards.
Now down 28-0, NIU could have folded their tents, but superback LeShon Johnson showed the Hawks why he's a consensus All-American.
Ball, he's at the 25. Cuts back, he's at the 20. He's at the 5, and he's in the end zone for a touchdown.
The score gave the Huskies new life, but not for long. They didn't count on Cedric Shaw, who blasted down the sidelines for an electrifying 35-yard gain to Northern's 11. But the drive stalled, and Todd Romano punched a 27-yard field goal through for a 31-7 lead. Northern Illinois added a late field goal themselves, and the Hawks left the field with an impressive 31-10 halftime lead.
Hey, no question about it. You were in command of the ball game in the first half and the second half. Your offensive and defensive lines really controlled things, didn't they?
Greatly improved, Jim. Just beginning to gel, really, offensively. That's three ball games. We played well against Michigan State, but not well enough to win. And then the Purdue game, we played much better. The first four times we got the ball, we scored. And in the ball game against Northern Illinois, we did everything very, very good.
Okay, we're going to take a look at that second half. You stay tuned.
Stay tuned for the second half highlights of Iowa and Northern Illinois on Hawkeye Sports Magazine with Hayden Fry.
What do you think about at times like these? Don't just think about it. Or there may come a time when that's all we can do. Support Ducks Unlimited, leader in wetlands conservation.
Introducing the all-new 1994 two-door Toyota Camry Coupe, developed and built in America.
Walkers fits the way Iowa lives, with shoes and boots that are perfect for any occasion. For outdoor adventures, that important meeting, getting to class in style, or for evenings out. And Walkers fits the family budget with family shoe club savings. Stop by any of Walkers' 10 Iowa locations, and you'll see why Walkers is a perfect fit for you.
Walk in to Walkers.
What's your active endeavor? Active Endeavors offers a wide variety of apparel and accessories to outfit your active endeavors and is Iowa's largest Patagonia dealer. Active Endeavors, where your outdoor adventures begin. Downtown Iowa City and University and 35th in West Des Moines.
This week's Active Endeavors Campus Spotlight focuses on Hancher Auditorium. Located on the west bank of the Iowa River, the University of Iowa's outstanding art showplace presents a surprising array of world-renowned performers, like violinist Pinchas Zuckerman, the Joffrey Ballet, and Kenny G.
Okay, Hayden, what a luxurious position to be in. You lead 31-10. You have about 350 yards of offense. Cedric Shaw's over 100 yards already. So what'd you tell the guys? Just go out and do more of the same?
Well, that's true, Jim. Our plan had been let's do as well as we can so we can play a lot of the young guys who've been practicing, working every day and never get into the ball game. And lo and behold, that's what we did.
And Mike Wells and company were ready in the first half for LeShon Johnson. That's when the first teamers were still playing. You held them, I guess, held them to 85 yards.
Well, that's true. And, you know, he had four big plays, they're all draw plays, that he actually bounced outside of the contain and then just outran everyone. He has exceptional speed. But other than the four plays, the defense had done a real fine job.
How'd you feel then about your defensive line and about your offensive line?
They both had improved, Jim. We rotated a lot of defensive guys. Tony Bates and Maury Crane couldn't play.
All right, well, let's take a look at the second half coming up right now.
In the beginning of the first half, the Iowa offense got things started right for the Hawkeyes. The Iowa defense did the honors in the early stages of the second.
And Geiser is standing down near the goal line. He's in the end zone now, leaving somebody to throw to. He throws downfield. It's intercepted. Hawkeyes have the ball, and they may get a touchdown out of this. Running with the ball. Scurrying around down there. Diving is Damian Robinson. He gets back to the 10-yard line. Deflected ball. Damian Robinson came up with it. Almost got a touchdown out of it.
However, NIU came up with a defensive gem themselves, stopping the Hawks on fourth and goal at the one. It was now Iowa's turn to come up with a big play.
Iowa leading 31-10 here in the third quarter. Now here's LeShon Johnson trying to turn the corner.
Got him.
Tackle in the end zone. Tackle in the end zone. It'll be a safety. Hawkeyes get the job done as they tackle LeShon Johnson in the end zone.
The Huskies then free kick to Iowa, and Burmeister put an end to anyone's thoughts that Iowa's offense would run out of steam in the second half.
People unhappy now. All right, and now here's Burmeister, fakes into the line. He looks, he has all kinds of time. He throws the bomb, he has a man wide open. Down at the 15-yard line is Harold Jasper. And here is Burmeister with the ball. Burmeister now hands off the second man, diving forward, diving touchdown, Cliff King. Cliff King, nobody touched him. The fake went to Ryan Terry. They followed the fake to the left side.
The two quick scores pushed the lead to 40-10. For the Huskies, the nightmare was far from over. Johnson fumbles on the northern 43-yard line, and Jason Olenzak recovered. Iowa wasted little time capitalizing behind backup quarterback Matt Ide.
Here's Ide. He delays. He's going back to pass. He passes, and it is complete. Anthony Dean. Cliff King is the upback. Here's the handoff to Shaw. Turns the corner. He's at the 20. He's still going. He rips away from one tackle, another inside the 10, down to the 7-yard line. First and goal to go at the 7 by the Iowa Hawkeyes, and a little cross-buck action there. Here's King into the end zone. Cliff King again. And he's become your running back of the moment. Cliff King, man.
With a commanding 47-10 lead, Iowa may have relaxed a little. Relaxing against LeShon Johnson is a mistake. The rest of the game was simply the LeShon Johnson show. He rocketed upfield for 47 yards here and shot upfield for 36 here, leading to a field goal. Matt Ide interrupted his performance with a nice touchdown pass to Jeff Antla, but Johnson stole the show with a spectacular run.
Okay, now here's the fullback going in motion, and the handoff goes up the middle this time, and running with the ball is Johnson, and here's Johnson. He could be gone. He's at the 50, the 40, 35, 30, 20, 15, 10, 5. He's in the end zone. Oh, man, oh, man, oh, man. This guy now has hit close to 300 yards, I think, today, doesn't he?
Man, oh, man.
Johnson finished with a Kinnick Stadium record 306 yards on 32 carries, but the Hawks walked away 54-20 winners.
Well, Hayden, I guess when you score 54 points, you got all kinds of possibilities for play of the game. And, of course, you had Cliff King scored 2 touchdowns, but you had some spectacular pass catches today.
Well, really did. Had some beautifully thrown balls. I guess Demo Odoms, that first touchdown gave us the momentum to get things really going.
How do you feel about Demo Odoms the way he's coming along?
He has deceptive speed, Jim. He has the speed to get behind the secondary, and in the few games that he's played, he has really matured and come on. Of course, he even dropped one behind everyone today. Matt Ide threw a beautiful strike to him behind. But Demo and Cedric Shaw from the same high school in Austin, Texas, and they ran on the national mile relay team. It sets a national record.
They can fly, can't
they?
They
can fly.
All right, well, we're going to send an example of that, our Napa Auto Parts play of the game. From where they actually spot the ball. The fake on the draw play, and Burmeister going for broke. Way down inside, it's an Iowa touchdown! Demo Odoms gets behind the defense, streaking down with track speed, a 34-yard touchdown.
More Americans trust Napa for everything they need to keep their vehicles running and to help them save, too. Get Napa halogen headlights as low as $4.99. Napa's Evercraft 30-piece socket set $14.99. And the Napa Legend 75-month battery, just $59.99 with exchange. So run to your nearest Napa Auto Parts store today.
We keep America running. We keep America running.
Started out as a paper girl. Now I own the company. Who'd have thought I'd be this successful? Well, I sort of did. 22 employees now. Got to make smart decisions. Benefits, pensions, 401ks. Think they can trust an old paper girl to keep things going? Always have.
For smart financial advice and ideas, come to First Star Bank. Main Street friendly, Wall Street smart.
It's really more than just a vocabulary.
We've got a track where it itches.
I think it's an attitude.
Son, that old dog won't hunt.
It's a style that's all his own.
Say yes to Buick.
Right now, you can say yes and get up to $750 cash back on the 1994 LeSabre.
Say yes, and you'll be driving with the class of a Texas High Port Picnic.
See your Iowa's Better Buick dealer.
News at the top and bottom of every hour. In-depth local, national, and international coverage from the Twin Cities' leading radio news team. First, fast and factual. News, weather, friendly conversation. WCCO News Talk 830. Weather updates around the clock on WCCO Radio. The most frequent and accurate forecasts from 3 full-time meteorologists. News, weather, friendly conversation. WCCO News Talk 830.
This week's First Star Player of the Week is Cedric Shaw. Shaw gained 145 yards rushing on only 16 carries. In honor of Cedric's performance, First Star will help to secure the future athletics at the University of Iowa by making a $500 contribution to the Hawkeye Horizons campaign.
Hayden, the Hawkeye Player of the Game. It can't get much better choice than Cedric Shaw, although everybody ran hard, I thought.
That's true, and you know, Cedric actually missed another touchdown. Burmeister threw a beautiful pass, and Cedric only got one hand on the ball, or he would have had another touchdown, but he ran exceptionally well.
And you got some good line blocking, and I thought the backs like Filer so forth did a great job of blocking.
Rodney Filer did an excellent job blocking, and in late in the ball game, when we had Chris Palmer and the little guy that I can't pronounce his name, did a tremendous
Shakur,
job.
Shakur, I think, isn't it?
DeMonte Shakur.
DeMonte Shakur, okay. Well, we player of the game, and now we come into our special feature of the night.
What do head coaches Lou Holtz of Notre Dame, Wayne Fonts of the Lions, Denny Green of the Vikings, and George Seifert of the 49ers have in common? All were former graduate assistants in football for the University of Iowa during the early stages of their coaching careers. Being a GA at Iowa has launched the career of some of the country's top coaches, and it's a legacy that today's student coaches look to uphold.
I really wasn't aware that all of those coaches were there, but if I can possibly be half as successful as any of those coaches, you know, that would be fantastic. That would be fantastic.
The only thing it means to me is that you have the opportunity. You know, you have, those guys had the opportunity and made the most of it and did a great job, you know, with what they wanted to do. I guess it just means you have an opportunity, and where you take it from there is up to you, I guess.
Graduate assistant coaches have a variety of duties at Iowa, and they play a big role in the week-to-week preparation for upcoming opponents. In today's environment of cutbacks in athletics, GAs are counted on to do more and more.
Double team, right outside of my job as a graduate assistant, I worked with Ted Gill the first year and worked on with the defensive scout team. And I would say that's probably the most important job that we do as GAs. And currently I'm working on the offensive scout team. We have to prepare our defense or offensive team for our opponents that's coming up each week. And if we don't give them a good picture, then we're not going to be able to, we might not have as much success on Saturday as we would have had.
Just try to help out and do the best coaching that you can. But mostly, though, it's organizing and arranging the scout team, make sure the scout team is motivated to do a good job in practice.
Of course, the biggest dividend for these students is the experience, and for Iowa's GAs, they couldn't find a better mentor than one of the best, Hayden Fry.
Coach Fry has coached for 40-plus years. He's just has a wealth of knowledge about a lot of things, more than just football, and it's taught me a great deal to be able to sit there and listen to his ideas on football and on some other things.
Motivator, organizational person. He keeps everybody going on track. I mean, you want to be around a person like that. You want to be around a winner, and he's a winner. And like I say, you cannot put a price tag on somebody like with the experience of Coach Fry.
Hi, football fans. I'm your host, Bob Della Rocca, and back again for his sixth year starring on Football Forecast Weekly is America's number one football analyst, Dennis Hogler. Thank you, Bob. It's great to be back for a sixth season. We'll have the insights and information you need to become a better handicapper. Watch us each week right here on this station.
Broker looking for a new challenge, Berthel Fisher & Company could provide the answer. Whether you want more money, the freedom to grow professionally, the potential to become a stockholder, an exciting array of investment banking services or products to offer clients, Berthel Fisher & Company has what it takes. If you have what it takes, call Berthel Fisher & Company today and ask for the free broker pack.
Here's a look at the latest Big Ten standings, brought to you by your Iowa Better Buick dealers.
Well, Hayden, I'll tell you, the Big Ten race is still a topsy-turvy affair, isn't it?
I think it's one of the greatest things that's happened, Jim, to have that many teams that close, and from week to week, you don't really know which team's going to win.
And you got Ohio State and Wisconsin tying, but neither team has a really easy road the rest of the way. It could all be decided the last week of the season.
In fact, most of the teams up to the top in the Big Ten have a very difficult schedule because most of them are playing one another.
And nothing comes easy for you guys either because you're facing a bunch of Wildcats who are playing like Wildcats.
I'll tell you, they've been playing exceptionally well and could have won at least three more ball games.
Okay, the next game, of course, for the Iowa Hawkeyes is back to the Big Ten race against the Northwestern Wildcats at Evanston. Let's find out what Northwestern has this year.
Before Gary Barnett arrived on the coaching scene at Northwestern, the Wildcats were a team struggling not just for wins, but also for respect in the Big Ten. All that changed last year, however, when the Cats took the league by surprise, knocking off Purdue, Illinois, and Wisconsin. They were just 2 points away from a fourth conference win against Michigan State.
In order to survive in this league, you got to surprise more than three. I took the place of a guy that only surprised three, so I don't like my my record right now. But we're going to be a better team than we were a year ago.
And despite a winless Big Ten record so far, they are a better team. Northwestern may have lost its element of surprise after last season, but they returned 10 starters on offense, including the lethal quarterback-receiver combination of Len Williams and Lee Gissendaner that gives the Wildcats the fourth-best passing attack in the league.
He sees the field well, and he can create after catching the ball. That's what separates him from other receivers. He not only catches, but after he gets it, creates.
Gissendaner, second in Big Ten receptions with six per game, certainly has the ability to excite. But with 14 interceptions already this year, Williams must look for better distribution, or the Cats' strength may quickly become an Achilles heel.
We've got three or four more receivers that got to step up, take plays.
Defensively, Northwestern ranks ninth in the Big Ten.
Well, Hayden, before we get into really talking about the remainder of the season, we get these two gigantic games coming up. I want to tell people about your wonderful cruise, and you're looking forward to that right now with this kind of weather, aren't you?
Jim, I could.
You could leave tomorrow, couldn't you?
I don't know what to say about the weather. Unfortunately, it's like this all across the Midwest, so we're not just isolated here in Iowa.
Well, take a look at the sign up there on the TV screen, and you can enter the contest to win a trip with Hayden on his wonderful cruise. And we'd also like to talk about Napa Auto Parts, because they're part sponsors of our wonderful Thursday night call-in show with Hayden Fry. Two of the stations, of course, our flagship station, WHO Radio and KDTH Dubuque. Now, let's find out about the rest of the season. Your guys obviously are playing with a lot more confidence.
Well, Jim, they are. You know, once again, we started with a very inexperienced offensive ball club to kick off the season, and we caught all those real good ball clubs, particularly defensive ball clubs, early, and just didn't give us a chance to establish any confidence, gain any momentum, score very many points. And now then they're really coming on. They've paid their dues, so to speak. And we're gelling into a pretty decent football team.
I want to ask you about the kicking on Saturday. I know it was windy. I know it was cold. But kind of strange kickoff for both teams.
For both teams, we missed some. We hit some good ones. We got one down on the one-yard line, got them pinned down, and it turned into a safety. And then when they had to punt the ball after the safety, it gave us great field position. We scored another touchdown. But we've had a difficult time. So many teams have great kickoff return people today. Uh-huh. That we're a little reluctant just to kick the ball to them and let them set everything up. You can see we don't do too good a job tackling in the open field. And so it's been a kind of a hit-and-miss situation.
All right, now we go to Northwestern. They got Williams and Gissendaner, one of the best passing combinations in the country. Is that their main thrust, the main thing they do?
Well, that and the option game. They have a steady running game. Their defense is a thing that's really impressive. They've really improved their defense.
Well, you know, getting back to the game on Saturday against Northern Illinois, really, their option, you just gobbled that up, and you didn't let them do anything. But when LeShon Johnson got the ball, it was a different story.
We put a lot of emphasis on the option play. I think Coach Brazier and the defensive coaches did a super job on that. What we didn't allow for is running a draw play and bouncing it all the way outside of our end.
Well, that was the guy himself who was doing that. Wasn't
That's right.
Okay, well, Hayden, congratulations to you. Let's make it four in a row, starting with number three this next week. Good luck to you and the Hawks.
Thank you.